There was a roadside seller. He sold caps. He went to different villages and sold his caps. Go through this lane or that one. Pass this alley or another. Walk around the houses and pass through marketplaces. He roamed around a lot selling the caps. Red cap, green cap, yellow cap, blue cap, black cap, grey cap, white cap, orange cap, caps and caps, colorful caps. The caps were kept in a trunk. He carried the trunk on his head and roamed around the town. He used to live on whatever money he got by selling caps. One day, he came to a town and roamed around selling caps. He shouted in a high-pitched voice, marketing his products.
Caps are for sale. Colorful caps for sale. Small caps, large caps, short caps, tall caps, flat caps, puffed caps, compact caps, expanded caps. Whatever you tell, caps are here for sale. Color guarantee, product guarantee. Cloth lasts long, so does the stitch. Caps are for sale. Fair price and less price. Cap on your head, style far ahead. Caps are for sale. Colorful caps.
He sold caps till afternoon and then he was tired. He went outside the town and sat beneath a tree. He ate some bread and rested in the shadow of the tree and he slept tight. There were a few monkeys on the tree. They saw the cap seller. He was sleeping. There was a trunk near him. The monkeys were curious to find out what was there in a trunk. One monkey took lead. He climbed down slowly and reached the trunk. Slowly he opened the trunk and found that it was full of colorful caps. He observed the cap seller and found that he was fast asleep and snoring. He decided to trick a cap seller. He signaled his friends on the tree.
All of you come down quickly.
All the monkeys swiftly climbed down. He whispered to them,
pick one cap each and climb on the trees. No mess, no clutter, don't make any sound.
The monkeys were flabbergasted to see the colorful caps. All of them picked up one cap, climbed and sat on the tree. Everyone wore the cap on their head in style. They were chattering among themselves and passing their time. After completing his sleep, the cap seller woke up. He yawned and stretched his hands to loose them. He stood up to leave for his business. He turned to the trunk to find it open and empty. No caps? Alas! He realized that a thief came and ran away with his caps. But how to carry on his business? The cap seller became sad, disappointed. He sat down. He started to think on where to find the thief. The monkeys were enjoying the sorry state of the cap seller. They started laughing at him, showing their teeth. When he heard the weird sound of laughing monkeys, he got up and startled. He looked up. There he saw all the monkeys wearing his caps in style. He realized now that the monkeys had created this problem. But now, he was worried about how to get his caps back. The tree was tall and straight and very difficult to climb. Also, what if they run to another tree when I climb up? Then he threw stones towards the monkeys. But they were sitting up high, and hence the stones did not reach them. The monkeys plucked the fruits and threw them down. The monkeys stopped throwing stones and irritated. The cab seller put his hand on his forehead. The monkeys also slapped themselves on their forehead. The cab seller understood that the monkeys are imitating all his actions. He got a brilliant idea. He threw his cap on the ground. Immediately, the monkeys also threw their caps down on the ground. Without delay, the cab seller collected all his caps, put them in the trunk, and went away to sell them.
Caps for sale! Colorful caps for sale!